Good Packer Nation morning, guys and dolls. It is Monday. A little cloudy here today, but getting ready to talk a little Packers action. We've got a slight bit of news, a couple little tidbits of news, and we've got the combine coming up. So things are going to start happening pretty quick here, moving then into free agency. And then, of course, a lot of talk to a lot of discussion to be made before the draft then. And so let me know who you are and where you're coming at me from. We'll do a little Packer Nation roll call as we get started on this Monday morning. I hope you had a fantastic weekend. Mine was fairly productive and great. Roger's here from La Crosse, my mama's hometown. Hi, Mom. And last week, we had just about every state in the union, I think, represented, including, I think, Vermont or New Hampshire up there, which it had been a while since I'd seen anybody from, like, the Northeast, so I was interested to see that happen. I hope everybody survived the snowstorms that went through last week and are, we're well on our way to spring here. Wayne is here from South Carolina. All right, just down the road a little ways. Who else is on this morning? I got my coffee going. You need it on a Monday morning. Solis is here from Texas. LB is here from Green Bay. Wendy is here again saying good morning. Good morning. How are you? Bryce is here. The algorithm is back. George, good to see you from South Carolina as well. Well, it's that time of year when, as much as you want to talk about the Packers, basically what we're doing is we're so guessing right now. We're so hoping right now. And I know I can get a thumbs up or two for people that are hoping that Ted Thompson finally makes good on what everybody else is saying, that we're going to be more active in free agency. Hey there, Dan from Sheboygan. That's where my sister lives. We ought to catch up with each other one of these days when I'm up there visiting Sis, Chad and Mitzi up there, and the little nieces and nephews. We're hopeful that the rumors are true. We're kind of just, we're sitting on our hands till the 9th, and we'll see what happens after that. Hey there, Jonathan. We got Texas pretty well represented. I don't see anybody from California just yet. Kind of surprised. NFL's, yeah, LB is mentioning that might be the comment of the day. Juan is here. Good morning from Moreno Valley, California. There we go. I knew you were out there. Juan, good to see you, man. Gary is here as well. Says good morning to Packer Nation. Chris from Chattanooga, just down the road from me. Opposite sides of this, of a very, very wide state, but good to see you, Chris. There yet another, I think it was maybe the Daniel Jeremiah's mock, that now, once again, we're seeing more and more people with the Packers picking T.J. Watt in the first round of the draft. Now, we got Hans from Monroe, Wisconsin. All right, up in my neck of the woods. Abram is here from Visalia, California. What a cool name. Mark is here from Washington. Fort Lickerdale in the house. Tom is here. Good to see you. I don't know. Emoji me your thoughts on TJ Watt in the first round, because I know there are some, and I am kind of one of those, that have concerns as to whether TJ Watt is a guy to pick up in the first round, or if he's going to be available. Maybe we trade up into the set in the second and are able to get him and get another player before that. We see a little love coming across the screen already. Jerry from Michigan is here. Good to see you, Jerry. And let me know what you think about TJ Watt in the first round. I mean, it's the end of the first round, but is it a reach for a guy like Watt? And I think we talked about this last week, and I posted on it, you know, what's in a name? How much can you put on the name? This guy is a Watt. There is a certain pedigree there that is not to be ignored, but how much weight do you put it on it? Renee is here. Can't wait to see the Packers again on TV this season. No kidding. I'll be geared up for training camp. I'll be geared up for the preseason. But it's all like, as training camp gets here, you're all excited. And then you start watching it. And then you're like, man, I just really want a game. I want to see preseason. You get all geared up for that. Then the preseason games come and you're like, you know, these games are so vanilla. I really want the real regular season to be here. And it just works that way. But it's all exciting and it's all fun. John is here. I missed the comment there. John is here from Bakersville, California. Sam, Roger, and LB. Rodgers got Packer withdrawals. I'm sure some of you can agree with that. Erica is here. Jeremy is here. Need a cornerback in the first round. And that's the kind of the question. You know, this is a Packers team that needs help on the defense. No question about it. We've got the free agency period coming up right after the combine. Is Ted Thompson going to actually make a move? Now, we saw him let Sam Shields go, let James Starks go. And once you see those, and now that number, that cap number is in the $40 million range, and you start to wonder if the rumors aren't true. However, if we pick up a cornerback in free agency, do you then get a guy like TJ Watt in the first round of the draft? Does it make more sense then? Or do you stack the cornerback position? In that case, yes, you're going to get a good corner at the end of the first round of the draft. However, now you've got to ask yourself, can you pick up TJ Watt and get a good corner in the second round? So it's getting somewhat interesting in that regard, but a lot of it, I think, depends, at least in my opinion of it, is Tom wants to go ahead and get TJ if he's available. Wendy is waiting for the combine this weekend. It is so coming up. But it is going to get a little more complicated, and then you add to that the combine. So you look at some of these guys, maybe TJ goes in there, and maybe his combine numbers are really off the charts and really eye-opening. So now you're going right back to the drawing board with some of these questions. Now you roll that in your head, and then Ted Thompson, maybe he gets an outside linebacker in free agency rather than a cornerback. Now you got the TJ Watt question back again, and you're probably looking at a corner. So Sam says King is a really good second round corner, and I tend to agree with that. And I think the algorithm would love, he may not agree with second round. So it's going to get super interesting, super fast. I'm actually super excited. If you can't tell, we're going to be moving to a new format with the combine coming up. We're going to be again going Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We may move to every day during the week. I'm going to structure the format of the show a little better for you because we're probably going to be, hopefully by next week, we'll be adding ads so I can go warm up my coffee in the middle of the show. You guys can take a stretch, whatever you need to do. But with that said, my feeling is I got to up the ante a little for you guys because you guys and everyone has seemed very copacetic with us putting the ads in. It's absolutely a necessity because otherwise this is about 3 or 4 hours of time that I can't account for in paying the bills. So that's where we're at with that. But that the only reason I say that is because I'm pretty stoked. I think we're going to be doing some fun stuff. Thanks, Wendy. Got this at the pro shop. I think we're going to be doing some fun stuff. We'll have some cheese roasts. We'll have some character stuff. We'll have a lot more news, and we'll start to organize the show a little bit better. Joey's asking, is Lacy still with us? As of right now, he is. We'll see what happens when the free agency period begins on March 9th, right after the combine. And guys, you can emoji me your thoughts right now on Eddie Lacy. He is a big topic of conversation and is somewhat polarizing in Packer Nation right now. Emoji me your thoughts. Lacy's return. Should we lock this guy up? Or do you have major concerns? Maybe about his injury. Maybe about his ability to stay in shape. The guy was balling when he left the scene in 2016, and I had that comment made, and I agree with it, because during the Cowboys game, he was the best offensive player we could put on the field, and he was already hurt. He got hurt worse, but he had a fantastic, fantastic game then, but that doesn't take away the questions, and I see a thumbs up. I see a couple angry faces. I think I saw a heart come across. Skyler, of course, saying keep him on a one-year deal. Let's get him this prove-it deal, heavily incentive-laden. The problem is whether if he goes out and tests the market, maybe that number gets higher than we want to do right off the bat. Now we're kind of up against the wall, and you know Thompson, he's not going to overspend. Tom says he was balling in the kitchen too. All right, Tom. This is true. I also saw him and Hundley do a live Facebook voting of them just like walking around. They were going snowboarding or something. And honestly, it was a little bit weird. I have to be, yeah, I mean, it was it was kind of, I get that he can go live, but sometimes I think as a pro player, you might want to kind of be careful what you do, and it was a little bit strange. All right, Jason says, everybody emoji me your thoughts on Jason's comment. Let him go and get Jamal Charles. Jamal Charles, I don't think has been released yet, but expected to be released from the Kansas City Chiefs. And of course, when I mentioned Jamal Charles, we know the next name on everybody's tongue that wants to go get a free agent running back is going to be Adrian Peterson. You can emoji your thoughts on that as well. I've got a laughing face, which I think says, you know, MJ, do we re-sign Lacy? We know he has potential, but has injuries. We take chances on more proven guys that are also injury prone like Charles or Adrian Peterson. It's a good question. That's basically what we're asking. We've got some love out there for bringing in a vet. Some say too old. Tim says too injury prone. Skyler says spend the money on cornerbacks, not running backs. I tend to tip my hat to that. I tend to agree with you, my friend. Jake, both also injury prone, and they are. They are both injury prone. Adrian Peterson is washed up. This is a topic. This is a hot button topic. I'm loving it. Roger, he's a butthead. I don't know which one you're talking about. Adrian Peterson, probably. What about Latavius Murray? Well, we've got there's a lot of questions. Then the problem with trying to answer this question right now is it all comes down to what do we do with Lacy? Now, if we're able to talk to Lacy, get him in on an incentive-laden one-year contract to prove that he can stay in shape and that he's going to come back healthy, then I think all the other names are kind of off the table. And we did have last week, we posted for you guys, Eddie Lacy has been doing some hydrotherapy. He's been running in water. So basically what it is him running in a slower environment that also takes, with the buoyancy, takes a little weight off of him, which maybe we could just play football in a pool and Eddie Lacy would, you know, he wouldn't have a weight problem then. Maybe that's what we got to move to. All those in favor of the Packers playing in a swimming pool, I don't know. I think I'll just watch water polo for that. Wendy, Eddie Lacy is going to be more healthy and a better runner. And I'm one of those that I think if you can get Eddie Lacy without overpaying, I'm with you, AJ, keep him. Because you get him on a one-year deal. It's basically like his contract year this year. And you know, you always have to be careful because you get a guy in a contract year and you see him play great. Nick Perry come to mind. And you sometimes in the back of your mind, you're wondering, was he just playing that way because it was contract year? Well, if we can get him on a one-year deal, it basically gives us a reset on that same formula. And yet we don't have to deal with it until he proves it at the end. Lindsay is here. Got to crash for another shift. All right. Rest well. And may visions of Packer sugar plums dance in your head. I don't know. I was kind of reaching on that one. Great hard rushing back. Yeah. And Rogers says earn his money. Yeah, I think there's many. There are those in Packer Nation who have major questions about Eddie Lacy. But I've got this sense that if the Packers and Ted Thompson, kind of this is his MO, if he does bring him back on a one-year deal and he does it and it's an incentive-laden deal, I think most in Packer Nation aren't going to be too upset. Maybe in the draft in later rounds we can pick up a running back. We've got guys we can bring back. We've still got Kristen Michael on the table. Jeff Hayes, how you doing, my friend? Good to see you. We've still got Kristen Michael that's, you know, a free agent as well. There's some people we can play with, guys we can bring back. We will see. What a topic. It's, you know, and it's, isn't it funny? It's funny to me. In an off season where all we really, it seems like we really should be talking about, and all we talked about in terms of what we need during the regular season was defense. And now in the off season, this offense, this running back position has become a real hot button topic. And it's going to start coming into focus when this free agency period comes around. And Jeff is agreeing, and I completely agree with you, that Eddie's a beast if he can stay in shape. And that's why, you know, if we can get him back without him being able to sort of rest in his laurels on a one-year deal, then, but again, it goes to, you know, this is a guy that's going to be able to test the market. Is somebody out there going to look at Eddie Lacy and say, listen, we can get this guy in the building, we can have an immediate upgrade to our running game, take pressure maybe off a quarterback that we need to do, and we're willing to pay this guy the money. Then it all could go downhill for us very fast. I just don't think with the injury that Eddie Lacy is going to have the leverage that he would have had. Had he played out this season, I mean, it was a 1,000-yard season. He was on pace to have his best year ever. And I don't think there's any doubt that Eddie Lacy was going to make his money if he was able to play out the year. Now, the way it worked out, again, I talked about this several times. The way it worked out, even though we didn't make the Super Bowl this year, but we did make the NFC Championship, and we did it having this revolving door at the running back position for a lot of time. Now we have the discovery of Ty Montgomery, the possibility with the injury of bringing Eddie Lacy back. So this may be an actual help. The situation with Eddie Lacy may be a help for us come the 2017 season. I hope so. All right, definitely, MJ says, definitely think the defense is the most important, but at the same time, we need to give A-Rod as many weapons as possible. Need a great back to help take all the weight off his shoulders. There's more to that comment. I wish I could like these like I could before. And I agree with that. I definitely agree. And that's why when I talk about Ted Thompson, you notice he drafts wide receivers. Keeping running backs and wide receivers and tight ends in the hopper, I call it. And the same thing with the offensive line. There's nothing wrong with that at all. Nothing wrong. And we certainly don't want the same situation we had in 2016 at the running back position. And I think Jake is kind of describing the ideal scenario. Lacy on a one-year deal, keep Ty, spend your money on the defense, and maybe spend a few draft picks, quite a few draft picks on the defense. Which is one of the items of news. Packers picking up a fifth-round draft pick, a late fifth-round draft pick, as a compensatory pick last year with the exit of Casey Hayward. Also, Scott Tolzien went out the door. The language of the compensatory pick kind of made it clear that it was the exit of Hayward that gave us our compensatory pick. We got one. Some in Packer Nation feel like we should have got more. Out of Casey Hayward, there's a formula that they use, has to do with length of contract, their performance, and the amount of money that's involved, I believe. But the Packers will pick up an extra draft pick for Ted Thompson. And you can tell me right now, if you thumbs up, that you would like to see Thompson trade that pick to move up in one of the former rounds. Or angry face, if you want Ted Thompson just to stand pat, and stockpile picks like Ted Thompson, generally speaking, does. So we have, and this is a tradable pick for the first time, this compensatory pick. It's not going to have a huge amount of leverage, but if it comes with a package, we might be able to move up and maybe get a guy that could be more of a difference maker. Who knows? And I didn't catch the name, but somebody's asking, think we'll sign back Cook? I think so. I mean, I think he's got to be one of these guys that's on the plate. You know, Aaron Rodgers has also talked about it. You have to figure Ted Thompson, part of that money that he's got, you know, now with Shields gone and Starks gone, is kind of earmarked for making sure he comes back. But in addition to the Packers offense, and again, going back to the comment, You cannot overstock offensive weapons. We don't want to overpay for them, but we can't overstock offensive weapons for Aaron Rodgers. And running back position is one of those. Tight end is another one. We got Kelly from Calgary, I think, if I saw the name right. Just one pick for us. Ted Thompson has had some success with these compensatory picks. Let's read off some names, guys. How about Josh Sitton? You can thumbs up, and if you're basically, you need to understand, if you thumbs up right now, you're actually giving a thumbs up to Ted Thompson. Okay, so keep that in mind. We've got Josh Sitton on that list, Mike Daniels on that list, Richard Rodgers on that list, Blake Martinez and Dean Lowry on that list. So, guys, we have had some success with those compensatory picks. I like the idea that they're tradable this year. And we have, here's the breakdown. They give out 32 of these picks, and it's really, really bizarre. We've got four extra picks given to Cincinnati, Cleveland, Denver, and Kansas City. Miami got three, the Rams got two, and Seattle got two. Everybody else got one pick, Arizona, Baltimore, Carolina, us, Indianapolis, New England, the New York Jets, Pittsburgh, San Francisco, all with one pick. So, and Richard is saying, Ted Thompson has done great in the fifth round, and you do, you know, this is the one thing that I can't see taken away from Ted Thompson. And Bryce is mentioning the same thing. We're a draft and develop team, so it's nice to see these later round picks pay off. And Thompson, I think, has done a nice job. We'll see what happens this year. And I think this is one of those years where we're going to get a guy that can be a contributor. So we shall see. What was I going to say about that? Oh, and also having to do with that in terms of the draft, Packers picked up a guy, Matt Malaspina, is going to join the Packers scouting department. So I want to just say from Packer Nation, you guys can put a heart up for Malaspina. Just give him a heart to say welcome aboard. Spent 11 years with the 49ers. Before that, he was with the Seahawks. So he and Ted Thompson, I believe, have worked together in the past. And I'm excited in some regard. It's good to have a guy that's got some experience, that's familiar with our system then, that believes in draft and develop. The only thing, I still think we need to maybe balance out draft and develop from time to time. Years like this, when we see that where there's a big gap between our offense and our defense, not just in how we spend our money, but in who, you know, how well we play, which they sometimes correspond. That we may once again sign back our own players and do little or nothing in free agency. I hope we do a little more in free agency. I hope the rumors are true. Bryce says, I think he and McCarthy will work well together. Philip is asking if this is the cat that was responsible for Colin Kaepernick, and which is likely the case. Now, I will say for Kaepernick, you know, there was this thinking for a while there, and it's sort of going the way of all things now, that there were quarterbacks that were going to change the position. Malaspina may have been one of those guys that bought into that. This is proving to be not the case. James, we talked about TJ a little earlier. TJ! Kaepernick sucks. Yeah, and we've seen what happened with that. He had a supporting cast around him, but the fact of the matter is he just doesn't have the kind of accuracy and the football mind that is required to be an elite quarterback. What he would do is rely on his legs. But you got guys in today's NFL like Aaron Rodgers that have all the physicals, that can put the ball on a dime, that can throw every pass on the field, but yet they're also dangerous if there's no one open, and but they're not looking to run like Kaepernick did. So we'll see how Matt does. But good to have you on the staff. Welcome aboard, of course. And interesting that we bring someone into the scouting department, and so far no news on Elliott, you know, no other news in the scouting department. Everything is status quo as it looks like, as it stands right now, so we'll see. All right. Need proven pros at Wayne's saying we need proven pros at corner, which I agree with. Danny doesn't see how we can talk about football in February. I don't see how you can not talk about football in February. My gosh. We got the combine coming up this weekend. We got a lot of hopefuls out there. We got a lot of people going to be keeping their eye, especially on how TJ Watt does. What does he do to his draft status in the combine? We've got immediately following that, on the heels of that, the free agency period. Danny, or LB, I'm sorry, is saying we need speed at the defensive back position. Yeah, and you know, we had that in Sam Shields. We have what we didn't have in Sam Shields was the kind of 6 foot one longer guy. I would love to see us pick up a guy that's got a lot of speed and also is over 6 feet. Would be great to see. And if we can get one guy in that defensive backfield, I keep saying this, and a lot of people agree with me on this one, so just thumbs up. I'll say it again. Do you feel like if we get one guy that can truly lock down a guy like Julio Jones, that can lock down a number one, that this defense does a complete 180? I mean, if we can get our guys back, of course, but we get one shutdown corner, I think that turns a lot around, because then you have this domino effect of our next best up moves down the chart. Do I think we should trade Hundley? I think eventually it's going to, I think next year is it? I think next year is going to be time. I just don't think it's Ted's MO. So I don't feel like it's lucky. I don't feel like it's likely. Rollins and Randall will be better. This is another thing I wanted to talk about, Jonathan. Thanks for bringing it up. Get another safety, pair him with Dix, who's elite. Have a standout year. I think we're... yeah, I don't know. Well, Ryan, here's my point. Ryan's disagreeing, and this is point well taken, that, you know, we can get lockdown number one, but you still got, there's, you know, these teams have all the way down to the third receiver. Some of these guys are very good, but the domino effect I'm talking about has to do with my belief. I believe between Randall, Rollins, and Gunter, we're going to get two really good guys out there, and we've still got, you know, possibly Hyde in the mix. I think those guys are going to be fine, to be honest. And I think Gunter took a lot of flack, but he got thrown in the fire and he learned a lot. Randall and Rollins, injury prone. The big question, I think, and this is where maybe we're on opposite sides, is this, you know, the Randall and Rollins situation. Do you feel like those guys are going to be like Devontae Adams, where by next year comes around and we find out that, wait a minute, these guys were just hurting the whole year. And now they maybe get a year healthy, and they show what they can do, because they're going to be third-year players. It's pretty much do-or-die time for Randall and Rollins. And Gunter, same thing. I think out of that mix, we're going to get a guy that can actually – I think out of those three guys, we get two that can really play, that are going to really play. The competition goes up. You bring in a veteran that you know is going to lock down maybe the number one outside spot. Then the competition amps up. We're going to bring have a rookie come into camp. I know we'll have at least undrafted rookies come into camp. The competition is going to get amped up, and I think that it would absolutely transform not just the defensive backfield, but because of that, and the domino effect, the next best player then is going to be, you know, your other outside. Then you're going to get your slot guy out of that next best, probably. And I think the entire defense changes. And I think our pressure starts to change because we can actually cover for a change. When the pressure has to get there in 2.9 seconds, it becomes very difficult. James is here from Ontario. How you doing, eh? I forget. I was talking to somebody from Ontario last week. Grew up in Wisconsin. I'm a Wisconsin boy. So we used to cruise up there. Thunder Bay. Gorgeous and great fishing, man. Oh, love it. Skyler says, got to get some proven corners. That's where I would love to see us go in the draft. I would love to see us. I mean, you know, it makes some logical sense. If we let Sam Shields go, that we need to go out and find a replacement. And not bad, eh? All right. Yes, it is awesome fishing. My cousin came down a couple years ago to watch the draft with us, and that's pretty much all we talked about. We just reminisced about fishing in Canada. So much fun. Love to go back. Bucket list trip coming up. All right, yeah, and we've got Gary on talking about pass rushers. We do need pass rushers. We definitely need to amp up our pass rush, and here we are maybe back with TJ Watt, talking about TJ Watt again, all right? Okay, guys. What are my thoughts on Captain? Yeah. Captain Munnerlyn, here are my thoughts, okay? And it's going to be a little bit generalized. And GJ is saying it. I've been kind of an AJ Boye guy. I think we can get him in. I think he'd be fantastic. But Munnerlyn, I think, is the kind of guy Ted Thompson might just sign. I think it seems more likely that Ted Thompson goes after and gets a guy like Munnerlyn. But I'm not very excited about it. I mean, it would... This veteran presence is helpful in a lot of ways. Nicholas wants Boye as well. Question about Boye is, you know, he has not played that many snaps. It was a kind of a one-year wonder sort of a situation. So we will see about that. I don't think so. His passer rating against, don't quote me on this, but his was best in the league, I believe, or best of the free agent class. It was good. It was like in the 50s, I believe. I want to say 50.8 quarterback passer rating against when throwing AJ Boye's way, better than any of the other free agents out there. So we shall see. And it's coming soon. I mean, it's right on us. Now, I have said I'm not going to be holding my breath. Jeff is out there today, and he believes, and y'all can put up a heart if you're with this or if you just want to see it, that Ted Thompson's going to make a splash this year. He's going to go after somebody early, and he's going to bring him in right away. Because I spent a whole show laying out, and a big long post too, laying out why I think we have to temper our enthusiasm, curb our enthusiasm, because we might have to wait. We usually do. And GJ is mentioning the 9.4 yards per attempt. And that's, I guess, if I'm remembering right, because I remember reading that as well, AJ Boye's stat against, which was he was the only cornerback less than 10 yards per catch against, if I remember right. So this kid, I'd love. And Jeff, if you're right, I hope you're right. I think I mentioned that in the comment. I hope you're right. And if Thompson goes out, that would be a guy that I would be really stoked about. JB says, Ted, pull the trigger. Right. So that said, then you've got one guy that's basically going to have to pick up the slack. And you bring in a kid like that. I think he's 26, I want to say. AJ is... You bring him in, he comes into a Packers organization. He comes from the Chiefs. Because of the Eric Berry situation, the money may not be there for both of them. Hi there, Linda. And he comes from a winning organization to another winning organization, but he comes to a Packers coaching staff that really makes no bones about it. When you go out on the field, you have to perform or we will find somebody else. And I think three of our cornerbacks are going to be fighting very hard because they know these third year guys that their job in the NFL is on the line this time around. That's part of the reason I think we're going to do these three guys between the three of them. If we can bring somebody in, we're going to do really, really well. We're going to see this defense make a 180. Of course, there's other questions still to be answered. We've got other free agents that we have to address. We've got the draft. We still have to amp up our pass rush. But I do think it makes a big difference. I guess I'll say that much. And Ronnie says, we definitely need to get a number one corner. Yeah. And you know, we're saying logic tells you if you get rid of Sam Shields, you've got the money, guys. You've got to go out there and get a replacement for this guy. You can't. This is the thing. This is where the draft and develop kind of gets under my craw a little bit when we continually bring in rookies that are going to get thrown into the fire before they're ready. That's not draft and develop. I think my cousin Jeff, I'm not going to remember, but he had a good name for it. I'll have to come up with a good name or look up the name, but it's like draft and throw them in the deep end is what we do. That's not draft and develop, guys. We do a lot of draft and develop, but what we've been doing, especially at the cornerback, these three of these guys, and we basically draft them and throw them in the fire. That's not what we're supposed to be doing. And the balance comes in when you pick up a free agent or two in the offseason. And that's what I hope. All right, guys. Well, I think that's about what I had to talk about today. Like I said, I'm totally stoked because we're going to be moving to a new format. We'll throw in some breaks. but will draft and destroy. There you go. Gary, well said. That may very well be the label that sticks. Draft and destroy. I mean, we just go in and either we get them injured or we just throw them in and they're, I mean, look at, this is the thing that kind of gets me. There are no excuses. But once you're in an off season, you know kind of how the dust has settled on the year. And you look back on a guy like Gunter and you gotta say, man, I have to appreciate a guy that went in there and had to play elite wide receivers. And for crying out loud, he did everything he could. Now he's got to get better. And I would also love to see him move to a different, where he's not playing the number one. But if he does, in that case, I think we can truly have an upgrade in our defensive backfield, which helps everything even moving forward as well. Phil, did you make another funny? Wonder if I can scroll here. Nope. Oh, yeah. OJ may be available. Up for parole. Creates holes, can do some damage. Oh, man. The problem with OJ is that when he screws up, he won't take any blame for it, I'm the responsibility factor. Oh, man. This is one of the things. When we start next week with maybe a little bit more of an organized show, there will be a comment of the day. And Phil, I'm expecting you probably to win that one once in a while. Often, actually. You guys come up with the greatest comments, especially the ones that make me laugh. So there will be a comment of the day that I will call out just about every year. And heck, maybe then we'll take one of those on Friday because we do a little bit more loosely formatted show and we'll do comment of the week and we'll throw a free t-shirt your way or something for the guy who gets the comment of the week. We'll see. All right, folks, I am going to wrap it up for today. We had a guy hired on the coaching staff. We got an extra draft pick. There's a little bit to talk about. There's a little bit to be excited about. Maybe a little bit of change in the air. We got another new set of eyes on the scouting, these rookies coming in, a new voice at the table. This is always interesting. And it's a voice of experience, so I like that. We'll see where we go from here, guys. And after the combine, we're going to be bringing it because there's going to be a ton to talk about. All right, Josh says, go, Pat, go. You all can throw up a heart if you want on your way out for a Go Pack Go. I hope you have a fantastic Monday. I am going to see you guys back Wednesday, same pack time, same pack place, right here in the studio, otherwise known as my living room. Roger's got a football up there. We need to get Beck Child. He always punches holes through walls. Later, JB. Daniel is asking if we ever sign the squirrel. Ted Thompson sitting on his hands. You got to go out and get it done. This free agent, I mean, free agent squirrels, they're not a dime a dozen. There are not that many available. When they come available, you got to go get them. Hashtag sign the squirrel. See you, Richard. Bye. Pat says, go, Pat, go. Tom Adams, have a good one, my friend. Later, Roger. Oh, we got a lot of go, Pat, goes. This is the like extend the end of the show. Keegan says we can't sign the squirrel. He's too nuts. He would be hard to control. He's too nuts. Good one. Wendy says go, Pat, go. All right, folks, I'm going to let you go. You can keep rolling them out if you want. I'll read a few more comments. But yeah, big time. Go, Pat. We'll talk to you again Wednesday. And Julie says, go, Pat, go. By Mike, I guess. Kathy says, go, Pat, go. Wayne says, go, Pat, go. James says, the curtain call. Have a good one, guys. We'll talk to you later. See you Wednesday, Bryce. Go, Pat.